And apparently, Wong is a top-class vegetarian cook.
One love.
So she knows her onions, allegedly. I'm here all week. We are just about to...
One all. One, two.
I think a backhand side is definitely going to be more of a recipe for success. The forehand, quite upright when she takes it. It's not so powerful, but quite consistent.
3-1.
And of course, she's up against a lefty, which can be very tricky, as we spoke about.
It's interesting, isn't it? And 19, as we mentioned, Wong is only 21.
Both,
we've only been seeing them play for a minute and a half in this match, but both aggressive, they're both attacking. You don't tend to get too many young players now that don't play in that fashion, which is quite refreshing, really.
Yeah, I mean,
four.
A lot of people say defences are dying out. I wouldn't agree. There's a lot of top young defenders coming up and through, but just like lefties, they're less common, and that's because you have less time as a defender than you do as an attacker.
Three,
well, it
four.
Depends how far you go back as a defender, but you'd rather not be under the bombardment of attacks and try to make attacks of your own.
Well, that was brilliantly attacking from Wong.
Four, all. Four, five.
Singapore are going through a big adjustment patch because obviously Fang Chen Wei was their arrowhead.
Oh, brilliant.
Five,
from him.
Oh.
That really disappeared like a speeding bullet. Just
gorgeous.
Looks great and left-hander as well, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah. Beautiful pivot.
Net five.
Singapore, the last team to defeat China at a World Championships in women's. It was in the teams. Legendary final for them.
6-5.
But like I say, they're very top players, getting older now, so chance for the youngsters to come through, as we're seeing.
5-7.
That's a serve,
seven.
That was. Shovel serve with a lot of topspin. Misread.
Let. 5-7. 6-7. 8-6.
Pressure. For a tall player, she stands surprisingly close to the table.
Oh, best rally they've played.
9-6.
There she kind of came an arm's length away just to give herself more time. Serve's been trouble.
6-10.
Well, an apology for the bit of good fortune, but it was excellent defence in that rally from Wong. And she takes
11,
the opening game by 11 one, points to 6. So are we going to get a response here
love
from
one.
Wing Lam?
Ooh,
one, oh.
Came back so slow. Quite high, but thankfully for Wang Xinru, wide.
Oh. 2-1.
Well, can't do any better than that. Might be fairly early stages, but every point on serve she's had, Wong has won.
2-0.
The commentator's curse is afflicting us more than usual today, isn't it?
It is, Trevor. You're almost silly, aren't you, in table tennis to make a prediction, because it's just crazy.
Back in business there, though.
Flat, punchy backhand. There you can see it. Tough to counter. Less top spin to work with.
3-4.
Just not fully transferring her weight through her forehand, Ng Wing Nam. That was so much better. Really exaggerating that movement with her base. It's where the power comes from.
It's exactly, you sometimes see that with golfers, don't you, when they don't quite complete the swing, and it means the hands take over and the body doesn't do enough, and it affects the power and it affects the distance.
No, 100%. It's amazing how sort of, you know, not putting a limit on your follow through actually really helps your shot making itself. Yeah. It's like the manifestation, isn't it? Thinking about the end goal can really help you just achieve it if you keep working at it, keep conscious about it. You've got to fully commit.
Let. 5-6. Six.
One of the most interesting things a coach ever said to me a while back, it was just in an airport, I think. He said the worst phrase that's ever been invented in the English language, and I'm sure it translates elsewhere, is practice makes perfect. He said it's absolute nonsense. Practice makes permanent. And if you're not doing the right thing, you're just going to keep not doing the right thing.
Exactly. You've got to be practicing at the right thing.
Seven.
You could be practicing all day at the wrong thing. It's going to make you worse. Some players play better after a break.
Yeah.
For example, after not training at all. Sport is so mental, and all of these pros work like horses in the training ground, practicing multi-ball, endless hours.
Self-analysis, yeah.
But then, when they're on the table, Seven. In the irregularity of a match, they can't find their form. So many of them stiffen up. Like, how am I missing these balls? Well, when you add pressure to the equation, you can crumble.
Yeah, and obviously it doesn't matter what happens on a practice table. In a match situation, it does. And Wong's fought back here to level this second game at the business end.
8-9.
Had a couple of the nice long shovel serves into the crossover, but I doubt she's going to do it now. A bit shorter.
Well, that was a focused pace, wasn't it? That shot we gave you of Ng Wing Lam, and she certainly was focused, and it's earned her a couple of game points.
Extending nicely on the backhand, playing it again and again into the forehand to test the recovery of Wang Xinru.
That could have been nasty. Second it's the game to Ng Wing Lam to level, but
love one.
Well, tough to predict how this match is going to go from here. Thought Wong looked excellent in the opening game, but Ng Wing Lam has fought back well. Love.
Oh!
there. Not the best service there. She could tell in her reaction. Didn't execute it as accurately as she wanted to. It's amazing how early the point can finish. Straight away if your serve isn't good enough.
One,
that was so quick.
Three.
The recovery there on each forehand. And then she played that beckoning opening.
Crowd pleasing exchange though between these two women. That's great defence from
four.
Wong, and then turns it into attack in a microsecond.
Ooh, wow.
5-1.
Bit of fortune on the finish, but that initial flick was second to none.
I didn't see this kind of a one-sided scoreline coming after that second game.
Me neither.
2-7.
Strange, the ambience of this game here.
8-2.
She's just really reading the game nicely here. And is playing one shot with the next in mind. It's like chess in that way. You're investing in your shot making.
Nine.
And now the errors coming predominantly from Eun Wing Lam. Being put under nigh on incessant pressure by Wong. And it's got a 8-10 game points to re-establish that lead. Well, that game didn't last long, did it? 11-2. So one getting us underway. Game four.
Love one.
It was obscure previous game there. I mean, she won the game, but she just seemed like she didn't even want to be there in the previous. It was just like she wanted to win it without really working for it. And two really poor serves from Wong Xinru. This is definitely psychological. Definitely psychological.
3, love.
It's amazing, isn't it? She hardly got a blow in the last game, Eun Wing Lam. And now she finds herself 4 love up in this fourth game. By the way, probably hear some noise from around the arena. We've got 3 other tables in action here. And we'll be down to 1 by Sunday.
1-4.
I would love to see the percentage of matches won 3-1 compared to the percentage of matches won 3-2. I bet it's a lot higher in 3-2 actually. Because, again, the hardest point to win is the last, the hardest game to win is the last. And in a sport of such fine margins, it just emphasises how important emotional control is and staying present mentally. And it's so hard even for pros to do, you know?
Someone, somewhere would have, potentially, it's a path through to the next round compared to who they could have got.
And if you've got the right attitude, you want to be playing the best. And the winner of this will be playing one of the best, former world champion Wang Manyu.
Yeah, it's a great carrot that's dangling in front of these two women.
Four, five.
So overt in her body language, isn't she, in Ming Lan? That was a very prolonged shake of the head.
Well, I think it was a let.
I thought, I'm sure I heard it.
Yeah.
Four, five.
Yeah.
Just, I think.
So it has been corrected.
Yeah. Yeah. Very clever that, after that little break in play, to play the same serve, just a little bit slower and wider.
Yeah.
The key thing in table tennis can be play it just outside of your player's opponent's comfort zone.
6-5.
Neither of them look like they're enjoying themselves that much,
no,
do they?
No.
Even when they win a point, I think it just speaks for the amount of pressure and tension there is out there.
And there seems to be a sort of feeling of resentment towards the pressure, in a sense. You've got to enjoy it, haven't you? You've got to thrive under it.
Oh, there's another example of it. These service faults. Well, I genuinely think from here, whichever one makes the fewest errors, probably going to go through to the next round.
7-9.
So, just a glimmer here for Eun Ming Lam to level this match. A couple more points required. Big point this for Wong.
8-9. So many receive errors, Trevor, here.
9.
On serves that are attackable. Not quite good enough.
One serve has dropped from 100. There was only one way to go, but it's still significantly ahead of her opponent. But now, Eun Ming Lam has got herself a couple of game points to level the match. Swung at fresh air. And she held herself together here. Still game point.
Left. 10-9.
It was a top class 11, serve, 9. Just when she needed it. And she has levelled.
Love one.
Just flick the edge of the table from the racket of Eun Ming Lam.
Oh, goes for a big third ball kill. Good serve. Slightly misread. kept it just short enough to make it clear cut there for Wong.
Well, so far your short rally prognosis has proved absolutely correct. We may not have got to four yet, actually, Fraser, in this deciding game.
You just feel the nervousness. How much it would mean for both of these players here. Both under the age of 22, you know. To get the round to get to the round of a 32 in an event which is basically as strong as a World Championships would be amazing. But the way these two have played, without sounding too critical, I think Wang Manyu will have either of these two for breakfast in the next round.
It's interesting when Eun Wing Lam missed that shot straight round at a coach. See her here, maybe. There we go. Almost like she was looking for some kind of reassurance.
4-3.
When you can feel your opponent is nervous, that is especially a really good time for a long, fast serve. Because they might sort of unconsciously come close to the table prematurely. You can catch them out. When they're more relaxed, they're less likely to be caught out because they have more clarity in the mind.
Time up.
You have to play to win.
Four,
you can't play
six.
Not to lose.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Kind of came across that backhand a little bit more there, Eun Wing Lam.
Well, Wong's game is deserted there just when she needed it most. She's now by just two of the last nine points.
Far more assertive now, the Hong Kong China player. Hasn't looked like she's enjoyed herself, has she? As you say, Trevor.
Yeah.
She enjoyed that though.
8-5.
That was almost instinct, wasn't it? As much as anything else.
Yeah. Got to brace for impact.
6-8.
Well.
So back within a couple of points. Still hope for Wong Shinru.
Go! 6-9. 7.
Well, timeouts have been used, let's not forget, so no more real time to think things over or anything else but three-match points.
Yeah, body language has been a little defeatist, hasn't it, Wong, in the last few minutes.
8-10.
Slumps to her knees, Eun Wing Lam, as that was a chance to finish it.
I can completely understand the stress. If you've played the sport yourself, you understand how hard it is, but maybe this could be an example where she can turn it around.
Nine,
with the serves
ten.
As well. She's got a better chance.
One match point left. And she gets there. It's a massive win.